Okay, I'm going to do a video of a cat painting. I'm going to make a little postcard similar to the one I made the other day. So I'm going to start out by drawing the cat. Which you probably won't be able to see because I'm using a pencil, but I'm going to go over it again in pen so you'll be able to see it. Oh, I started too low. I'm going to do it again. Or I made him too big or something. Let me start again. Okay. So, I don't really have a reference, so, you know, I'm just sort of winging it. Sometimes that means, oh, that isn't right size. When I learned to do figure drawing, really already knew how to draw, I just didn't know how to do certain kinds of techniques. And so I took some figure drawing classes to help me learn to do the human body. So I was fascinated by faces. Couldn't seem to get the dynamics of the nose down. So I took these figure drawing classes in a community college. It gave me a lot more skills that I didn't have before. Okay. Now I'm gonna do like a little bird here. Give him a focal point to look out the window. I'd love to have things looking out the window. It's one of my favorite things to draw. Okay, here's the window. It's not very straight, but I don't really worry about that. I mean, really, if someone wants perfection, I'm using an Pitt artist pen by Faber-Castell. So if someone wants perfection, always advise that they take a picture. So here I am with the pen going over the cat that I will be painting. And I'm going to be using this Inca Gold Metallic Rub for my paint. I really enjoy that. I like the effects, and I like the ease of use. Okay, so I'm getting ready to do a show, at least that's what I'm hoping, at my beauty parlor, as we used to call it. Now they're called salons. So at my salon, I'm going to be having a show. So I've been producing a lot of little things that I hope to sell. Okay, so let me make his tail goes in here. And here we wanna. All right. Now I'm gonna paint, and I'm gonna use my cat tongue brush and my golden Tacklon Filbert to paint these. So a little water helps this ink spread easily, especially if you want to have a little control. Now I want to make the sides a little lighter than the middle here, where the back of the kitty will be kind of sticking out. So you'll see a little more of his fur. The thing about adding water is it thins it out too, so you have a little more control over the final outcome. So I can do a little thinner version for the lighter edges, and where I want to show a little more darkness or shadow or detail, then I'll use a thicker version of the Inca gold wax metallic rub. It's made with beeswax. I really like that. I feel like it's less toxic to be using products that are natural. Now this is a product made in Germany, and my brushes are made in the USA. They're made by a company called Treckle. And I like them very much. Okay, I have to kind of get away from the piece so I actually see how it's looking. Because I can't always tell when I'm close up. This dry a little bit so I can see how it's going to look. I do want to get a little more. Darkness right in here. I have a little background music for myself, but I don't want to really do any copyright infringements, so I have it very low so you can't really hear it. Okay. I'm not really letting it dry, am I? Okay. See a spot I can want to take some of the darkness away, so hopefully that's what this does. Yeah, that's what it did, so that's good. Now that I wanted it to have a kind of like it's got a little fur. tell that. Okay, so that's done. Now, what I want to do is the little bird. So, I'm going to do a little yellow head. And I'm using my, these are also from Germany. They're a watercolor pen. So the watercolor's in the barrel of the pen. And it's good for some things and not so good for others. So I want to do the wings a little more black. Okay, and so a little brown for the branches of this little tree that this bird is standing on. The end of. Okay, so for the wall, I think I'm just going to use a green like I did on my last drawing. I'm going to use a little watercolor. This is kind of a blue-green, cheerful color. So I'm not sure that's the right one. Here, I think a little darker green. Oh, that's better. I want to lighten this up a little. Okay, and let's see. I think I want to do a little outlining for him here. Okay, and now for the last part, I'm going to do the sky, which I'm going to do a blue color. One thing about these pens, because they're artistic pens, they're archival, they're acid-free. And you can paint and not worry so much about them running. Okay, that's it. I'm not sure I like the green so much, but there it is. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.